What's good out there, everyone? It's your main correspondent, Alan Taylor, and I'm back in the broadcast room yet again with another one. Yeah, you know, okay. Shout out to all my subscribers, Real Talk, 10 Toes Down, mad love to everybody, you know, real. You know, we keep it real with you. Appreciate it. This one here, you know, boggles the mind. It's crazy. Crazy scenarios, crazy situations. You know, it's definitely sad that, you know, you can clearly see people getting ran through the ringer, and you know, there's no way out. I'm just being honest with you. But, you know what I'm saying, of course we talk about brother Tory Lanez, it is what it is, they found them guilty, you know, and I know I haven't reported on this, you know what I'm saying, situation, because I really did want to wait till the end. I really wanted to see how this was going to all the way play out, you know what I'm saying, all the talk and this and the back and forth and the lies and the roundabout answers to things and people, you know, pleading fifths and things that, you know, only guilty people do. Let's just keep this real. That's the whole point of inventing pleading the fifth. You have some guilt in the situation, you know, but hey, it is what it is, man. Let's go here. Let's check out a few things. I got a news report here. Then we're going to go hear the father speak a little bit, you know what I'm saying, because he snapped out, for real though. I'm just being honest with you, you know, shout out to him. And then we're going to go to a young lady I found, you know what I'm saying, real talk, she's an up-and-coming lawyer, and she's going to be talking about it, so let's go.
A jury has found rapper Tory Lanez guilty of shooting fellow rapper Megan Thee Stallion after a 2020 house party. And now it is newsreader Christiane Cordero with more on the chaos in the courtroom after the verdict was announced.
Today, a jury of 7 women and 5 men decided rapper Tory Lanez's criminal fate. Guilty, guilty, guilty on assault with a semi-automatic firearm, having a concealed, not registered firearm in a vehicle, and discharge of a firearm with gross negligence. Lanez, whose legal name is Daystar Peterson, is convicted of shooting rap superstar Megan Thee Stallion in the foot after a house party in July 2020. Both sides built their case around jealousy. The defense has revolved around a jealous love triangle, while prosecutors shrugged that off as prejudice, saying her love life was only brought up in court because she is a woman, instead accusing Lanez of having a bruised ego.
Hold up.
What?
Listen, let me tell you, when you get your ass in court, they gonna dig up everything about your life. That's just kind of how that works. You in court, they not finna play no games with you up in there. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, see, that's how I know people don't be knowing the legal system. You know what I'm saying? They don't know what the hell they be getting themselves into. You know, for real though, it's just a bunch of dingbat shit. Let's go.
Go jealous of Megan's status. She testified he shot her after she insulted his career.
Constantly having to prove she's a victim because society sides with a man.
Megan testified on the consequences she has faced by bringing this case to court, but has felt the need to amplify the struggle Black women face in getting criminal justice as victims and feeling protected as women in the rap industry. The conviction eases her of the former. Her attorney tells ABC News, quote, "The jury got it right. I am thankful there is justice for Meg." While District Attorney George Gascon says, "You faced unjust and despicable scrutiny that no woman should ever face, and you have been an inspiration to others across LA County and the nation."
What the hell? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Yeah. It's sad world we living in. I hear people, you know what I'm saying? If you have any type of good thought processing in your brain and you clearly see what's going on, it's a sad world out here, people. It's a sad world. This is what we've come to. We're here. We're deep in the trenches, like I said once before. We're in the damn trenches, for real, though. You know, it's right. Hold up. It's right there. And the crows is out. For real.
Tory Lanez and the rest of the courtroom didn't really have a reaction when the verdict was read, but immediately after, there were so many emotions. His dad and his father's wife both stood up to yell at prosecutors, calling them evil and wicked. This was right after the jurors had exited the courtroom. So he was yelling at them. It turned into quite the scene. Tory Lanez at one point actually got up alongside his defense attorneys to try and de-escalate as they were escorted out, which took about a minute or so.
He's steadily trying to de-escalate situations. See, that's what's got you in this trouble right now, young man. You trying to provide your protection to people that don't need to be provided for. Now, I understand in the courtroom, he may have been trying to, you know, get his family to calm down. Let's just keep that one real. But if he never had gotten that business between them two prostitutes, you know what I'm saying, fighting over whatever they was fighting over, and had to left that shit alone, he'll be sitting at home. All right, let's go here. You know what I'm saying? We're going to go see what Pops had to say. Pops went off. So it is what it is. I know how it is. You know what I'm saying? And of course, you know, my father's gone now, but I had a father and he was a very firm man, just like this man is, about his kid. Like, seriously, I'm just being honest with you out here. You know what I'm saying? That's how it goes. But yeah, let's check him out.
To see my other child rise up. But I'm telling you, this court system is not for justice. It's about wins and losses, and they do dirty to do whatever they can. Jay-Z, let me speak to you.
He has kids.
Rock Nation.
Yes.
Because my son refused to sign a Rock Nation deal with you.
Yes.
And Desiree Perez, you wicked witch, you snitch.
Yes!
You turned on your co-conspirator!
Okay, here we go here. Here we go with this. Now, this part of it, I'm grasping, like, you know what I'm saying? Hey, whatever been going on behind the scenes, obviously, it's bigger than what we seeing. It's bigger than what we seeing here. Because Pops is on here talking a lot. Spitting out a lot of accusations, you know what I'm saying?
What the French toast is there to think about?
You know what I'm saying? He doing a lot. All right? You know, and hey, though, he pissed because they railroading his son, basically. I'm just being honest. Hey, you know, shit get real. Shit get real. And, you know, be honest with you, I think Tory Lanez's father is a pastor or something like that, too. If I'm not mistaken, I'm not 100% on that fact. But, you know, yeah, if so, you know, I'm a preacher's kid, so I understand where he going from. Like, you know. He gonna say what the hell he gonna say. I'm just keeping it real. He gonna say what the hell he gonna say.
All the whole mafia, one of you that was peddling drugs in this country, and you ruled on them before, so the Fed could give you a deal.
Now you think
all of you, trust me. I have intercessors, prayer warriors around the world, and they will not stop until you are cut off. No, we don't shoot you with guns, but we know exactly how to bring you down in the spirit.
That's it.
It's all done.
Let's go.
Open way, guys. Open up.
We are done. My Rock Nation tried to mess with my brother's reputation.
Liars.
Wow, even his little sister, goddamn, got in on it. Let's go. That's what's happening. Hey, ain't nothing wrong with that. You know what I'm saying? That's what's up, man. She love her brother. You know what I'm saying? For real, though.
Yes.
All right, but I'm going to end that there, real talk. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
What?
Man, wow. I tell you, man, they just out here lurking. You know, these damn crows, man. Y'all don't understand, man. It's real out here. It is real out here. Now, let's go here. Young lady, you know what I'm saying? AV to the seventh power. You know, now I've seen her plenty of times on the lead attorney's channel. So, okay, you know what I'm saying?
What the French toast is there to think about?
Not a damn thing, because I know she know what she's talking about when it comes to the law. Let's just keep this 100. Okay? So now that we're keeping it 100 out here, you know, we going to check out AV, you know, and let's go here.
Eastern Standard Time. So we'll go to Chrome tab and we're going to Times. Okay, so we have Tory Lanez found guilty of shooting Megan Thee Stallion. Mr. Lanez, a Canadian rapper, that's important, guys, because he might be deported, was convicted of firing at the Houston hip-hop stars after an argument in 2020. The matter became the subject of speculation and gossip on social media and in songs. Okay, there's a picture of Tory Lanez. So this happened in L.A. An L.A. jury on Friday found Daystar Peterson, that's his government name, a Canadian rapper better known as Tory Lanez, guilty of shooting fellow artist Megan Thee Stallion in both of her feet following an argument about their romantic entanglements and respective careers in the summer of 2020. I don't even like how they phrase this, like shooting her in the feet. We talked about this last week.
And hold up for a second. Before she dive deep off into it. What I want to know is, okay, they're saying in this report she got shot in both of her feet, okay? Follow me now. But for the longest, basic evidence shows she only got injured in one foot. So, I mean, somebody tell me something, you know. Somebody tell me something.
Some of you guys that were here. What does that mean? That means that we knew that there were fragments, like there wasn't like a direct bullet in Meg's, like both of her feet. So that was up for debate. We wanted to see the x-rays. And I think Vince and others that were in the courtroom mentioned that they did see that. They saw the medical reports, things of the like. But just how this is being reported, pay attention. Mr. Lanez, who is 30 years old, was convicted of 3 felony counts. Number 1, assault with a semi-automatic handgun.
Damn.
Number 2, carrying a loaded unregistered firearm in a vehicle. And number 3, discharging a firearm with gross negligence. From a legal standpoint, what is assault with a systematic handgun? That is putting someone in fear and apprehension, right? A lot of times you guys hear assault and battery and you're thinking that you need to be hit. There's another part of assault and battery, typically assault, where the victim is placed in fear for their lives. Okay. So that's count 1. Let's pay attention to that. Number 2, carrying a loaded. So if you have a firearm, if it's registered, all good. Loaded, no problem. But when it's unregistered, that's a different story. And, you know, you're a celebrity. You might want to register your guns just to make sure that they're okay to have and that they're licensed. No big deal. 3, discharging a firearm with gross negligence. Now, let's talk about the discharge. Whenever you shoot a gun, it's going to be discharged.
Basically.
But what they're saying is that he did this with gross negligence, meaning that you shot it in a way where it could have hit other people. You were being very careless, things like that. Now, what are we looking at? He is facing more than 20 years in prison. You know what I like to do now, guys? Whenever people are sentenced to years, I like to just times that by 365 so we can really understand how many days of their lives they are looking at spending in jail. And if he's 30 years old, 20 years is when he's 40, you times 20 by 365, we're talking 7,300 days. 7,300 days. He is looking.
Wow. Wow. 7,300 days. Oh, man. That seemed like almost a lifetime. You know, brothers out there, you know what I'm saying? entertainers, you know, I don't seem to understand how y'all are not getting it by now. Some of y'all are getting it.
And what the French toast is there to think about?
We have been, especially, you know, amongst the brothers, we have been placed in a position to where there's no care. There's no understanding. There's no meaningful purpose with dealing with certain individuals and things like that, you know. Sorry, but it's the truth. We as men, especially the tanned and darker men, we need to, you know, make sure that we protect ourselves at all times, you know. And sometimes that means leaving certain people alone. I'm just being honest with you.
And, you know, I'll stop for a minute because I don't know if you guys saw this. I saw this on Instagram earlier today. Tori's dad had a lot to say about this. And, you know, if you're a parent and your child gets sentenced to life for a significant amount of years, you're going to have an opinion on it, whether they did something or not.
Right, right.
And he was very passionate outside of the courthouse today. You know, rightfully so, we'll see. But it's one of those things where it's just like, the media's have been all over this. They've barely had time to breathe. And like I said, you have one side where it's like, hey, you know, black woman got shot. Great. The other side is, are we going to send an innocent black man to jail? Polarizing. Very, very polarizing. This is emotionally charged for a lot of people.
And still, that's what the hell just happened. Yet and still, that's what the hell just happened. Now, this is the deal here. The fact that they sent this innocent man to jail, and clearly a lot of the evidence between the lies that were caught on the stand, between the evidence, between everything possible that you could know, that this young man was not, he wasn't involved with, I mean, he was involved, but not to that degree as far as injuring, quote unquote, you know, the Meg the Stallion girl. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, let's just keep this real. We all, you know, I mean, what more has to happen? But, you know, whoever was on that jury, obviously were not thinking individuals. They were not people that actually know how to be on a jury. I mean, just, you know, that is ridiculous that they are trying to send this young man and were sending him, you know, God knows what the sentence is going to be. You know what I'm saying? I mean, Jesus, sending this man up the river for something that he didn't even do. Man, dude, he was better off pulling off that night and letting them girls just go at it. I'm just being honest with you. Fuck that. Fuck that. He should have left them girls there arguing amongst each other. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. He should have left them arguing.
Really is. Okay, let's keep going. So we know what the charges are. 20 years and he could be deported. Jurors reached a verdict after about 7 hours of deliberation. That's actually over 2 days. So this is why a lot of us were not rushing to this, because honestly, it's the day before Christmas Eve and Christmas, and who thought that they were going to come back? But maybe right. They just wanted to finish this off and get it done. But 7 hours over a span of 2 days is how long it took.
But see, though, that's another problem, too. I feel like, okay, if that's the case, and they felt like they wanted to go ahead on, get it over with, because it is the holiday season. I'm pretty sure the jurors want to go home and be with their families too now. You know what I'm saying?
And what the French toast is there to think about?
All right. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm thinking they rushed this thing. They rushed it. Instead of actually, you know, figuring out what the right thing was to do, they rushed it. They also was looking at the fact of who it happened to. So, you know, all this woman crap. I'm just being honest with you. you know, she's sitting around talking about some, you know what I'm saying, the system side with men. I mean, I don't see where it does at all. Oh, Lord.
The jury to deliberate. Following a trial that lasted nearly 2 weeks, so it was fairly quick, Lanez, who had been free on bail during the trial following a period of house arrest, was immediately taken into custody.
Basically?
So Tory Lanez got taken into custody.
Right there in the courtroom. That's how that works. That's how that works. Okay. So, you know, yeah.
Right? I mean, I have a little brother, so this stuff bothers me sometimes. Especially if there's holes in stories and we don't know what actually happened.
Thank you. And that's part of the whole damn point. You sitting around here, it is so many holes in this story. Jesus Christ. It makes Swiss cheese looks better. At least Swiss cheese don't have so many damn holes.
And what the French toast is there to think about?
Not a damn thing. What? Come on, man. Come on, people. I don't see how the jury sat in that deliberation room and did all that quote unquote fucking thinking and thinking this case through. And you just gonna send a dude up the river for no damn reason. I mean, you know, it's little reasons, but you know what I'm saying? Jesus Christ, not the reason y'all trying to accuse him of. And see, that's the point. You're trying to accuse him of a certain reason, which is, you know saying, putting quote unquote, let them tell it, fragments in this girl's fucking foot. So, I mean, you know. Man.
And there's evidence, but it's just crazy. Not 100%. I don't know. We're going to talk about reasonable doubt in a minute after I do the poll so you guys can see what's really going on here. But, you know, I just hope that if this jury found him guilty, that they actually mean it and they have concrete stuff here. Again, I haven't looked at this in a few days, so I'm reacting with you guys. That's why it's going to be interactive.
Man, even she got doubt. Let's just keep this real. Listen to the way she said that. She said that she hoped that the jury had the proper evidence to really convict him. And he actually is guilty of this. You know what I'm saying? She said she hoped. Come on, man. We always know when women talk about hope. Ain't too much happening with that hope. Oh, I hope I find this, or I hope this happened, or, you know, hope. We talk about it all the time. Women using hope. We already know that's a bad word when hope get used. I'm just saying, you know. Let's go.
We're going to do it together. Sentencing is scheduled for January 27th. Megan was not in court today. As the verdict was read, Mr. Lanez appeared motionless and stared straight ahead until his father stood up and began shouting at the judge and prosecutors. He said, "God will judge you," as bailiffs moved to block his path. The lawyer for Megan Thee Stallion said in a statement, "The jury got it right. I am thankful there is justice for Meg. The case, which played out both in, I don't even know, why do we use words like this? Tawdry tabloid narrative in a weighty referendum, what a sentence, on the treatment of Black women in hip hop and beyond, was closely watched both for its famous characters and what was said about the recent adjudication of alleged abuse by notable men such as Johnny Depp and Harvey Weinstein in the court of public. Court of public opinion. You guys saw the Johnny Depp trial. A lot of us watched that together. And we know that there were a lot of holes in Amber Heard's story. Not calling Amber a liar, but there were just...
Screw all that. Listen, people. And I understand, you know, this young lady here is trying to, you know, she got a career. So, you know, her wording can work a little bit different than mine's. This is the biz right here. You know, it's no way that there's holes in the damn story.
And what and, the you French know what I'm saying? You mean to tell about? Me
that, you know, the story is correct when there's holes in the damn story? That's not how that shit works, man. That's not how it works. You know, that is not how it works. If there's holes in the story and you could poke a hole through the story, that means that story is not a valid story. So why are we going to honor it? Let's go.
Simply a lot of holes in the story. Kind of like this one. Sounds a little familiar. Like there's just some holes. And that's okay from a legal lens, not calling anybody a liar. But if we're going to convict people and send them to jail, what was that number I gave you guys?
Right.
For over 7,300 days and deport them, wouldn't you want to be a little sure? I think we would want to be sure about that, right? Okay, let me change this view so we can bring the article back up and look at it together. Okay, so we're talking about some other popular cases. Lanez, not a household name before the case, has seen his celebrity profile rise since his shooting, earning explicit and implied support from the various corners of the hip-hop universe and influential blogs and social media accounts of the rappers turned talking heads of 50 Cent and Joe Budden. You know, I don't know if I agree with the Times on this. Here's why. I watched what Joe Budden said on this. He was talking more about Megan and her history in the industry and just people that they've mutually dealt with and they've seen. It was more along the lines of her business dealings, at least from what I saw. But y'all correct me if I'm wrong in the chat, and I'm going to catch up with you guys in a second. But yeah.
Okay. But you know, yeah. Basically, this is where we're going here. This is where we're going. That's where we're going. And I know for certain. That it's not going to be a delicious time. It's not going to be a good time. Man, I don't know what is happening to human beings to where y'all actually are so fucked up in the head to you would actually be sending, you know what I'm saying, people who are innocent to prison, you know what I'm saying, to fucking save face on some dumb shit. You know what I'm saying? Because you didn't want to bring up perjury charges on them women in court. Let's just keep this real. 100 right here. Damn it, I said it. Because if you kill your dingbat ass in court and you lie on the stand, that means at the end of the day, you can get perjury charges brought up on your ass. So to save face, everybody just worked together in order to make sure that this, the mad girl, even her partner, the chick, the Kelsey chick, or whatever her name is, you know, Jesus.
And what the French toast is there to think about?
I'm sorry. But, you know, to save face. And this is the world we're going into with our justice system. It's just to save face. They always want to look right. You know, so if the justice system is always wanting to look right, look, appearance, not actually being right, but just the appearance of being right. You know what I'm saying? If they want to always appear to be right, then how can we get any true justice in this country?
And what the French toast is there to think about?
I'm just saying. But it is what it is, though. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to all my subscribers. Real talk, mad love to y'all, man. Thank y'all for tuning in. You know, yeah, I just wanted to bring a little bit and put my quarters, nickels, and dimes in on the Times. You know how I like to do. Please hit that like, share, subscribe button out there. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to all my subscribers for, you know, even being here, period. Thank you. But yeah, though, you know, this is a sad situation. You know, man, I'm hoping this young man could get at least a little bit of light. But, you know, hey, it's crazy out here. But like I always say about this time, that, my friends, is the bottom line.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?
Said to myself, this is the business we've chosen. I didn't ask who gave the order, because it had nothing to do with business. I wish I knew.